Good morning students. Well, I hope you all are fine. So today we are going to start our 7th chapter, Europe, Location, Political Division and Physical Features. So in this chapter we are going to study about this continent Europe, about its location, political division and about the physical features. Location and political division. Europe has often been called a dynamic continent because it always been home of invention, discoveries and rapid rate of progress. This continent Europe is known as dynamic continent because this continent has always been the home for inventions, you know, new inventions, discoveries and a rapid rate of progress. Although a small continent, Europe is made up of 44 countries, with the largest being Russia and the smallest Vatican City. So in this continent there are 44 countries. The largest is Russia, okay, and the smallest is Vatican City. If someone asks, you know, the smallest and the largest country of Europe, you have to mention Russia and Vatican respectively. It is in fact a part of a giant supercontinent of Eurasia. Eurasia in the sense Europe and Asia ko combine karke term bana hai Eurasia. We will study this further. But it is regarded as a separate continent because of its distinct physical features and population. Well, Europe, this continent is a part of a supercontinent Eurasia, but it is always regarded as a separate continent because of its distinct features, physical features and population. The physical features are different, that's why it is regarded as other continent. Since the past few centuries, Europe has influenced the world politically, economically and culturally. Well, from the past few centuries, you know, when we talk about culturally and politically, economically, you know, in both of on these three terms, it has been influenced. Europe has been influenced to all over the part, all over the country. You know, when we talk about Renaissance, have you heard about this? Started from Italy. So this term, this Renaissance, rebirth, revival of, you know, tradition and culture, it started from Europe only. It started with the European explorers, traders and religious missionaries spreading their thoughts and beliefs of to distant land. You know, when people have started traveling, so it started from the Europe, the European explorers, traders, they have started their journey from Europe to the other parts of the world, and religious missionaries, whether the spread of cultures, religions, it gets started from the Europe, spreading their thoughts. You know, the great philosophers, they all belong from this European, this continent. Since then, Europe had led the world with its modern advance in scientific discoveries and technological inventions. You know, from centuries before, from the past few centuries, Europe has led the world with modern and advanced discoveries, scientific discoveries and technological inventions. Well, it's a midnight sun in North Cape. You know, midnight. Aapko pata hai? What is midnight? So we can see the midnight sun at North Cape. Now the next is location and extent. Europe is the westernmost peninsula of the giant supercontinent Eurasia and the second smallest continent in the world. It lies entirely in the temperate zone of the northern hemisphere. Now the location is, it lies in completely in the northern hemisphere and extends from the island nation of Iceland in the west to the Ural Mountain of Russia in the east. Now this is, you can see the map. So this is the physical features of physical division we are going to study in detail in this chapter. It extends from 30 degree north to 70 degree north latitude and approximately 25 degree west to 60 degree east latitude. This is the extent. The prime meridian, that is zero longitude, passes through Greenwich near London, from where GMT is taken for the international time. Jo hamara time decide hota hai wo yahi hai, Greenwich. The northernmost point of mainland Europe is located at Cape Nordican on the Nordican Peninsula, but sometime North Cape located at 71 degree north to 25 degree east longitude is taken as the northernmost point where the midnight sun can be seen from 14 July to 13th July. Okay, these are the, you have to note it down. You can see the midnight sun during this date. Europe at time declared as a peninsula of peninsula. Peninsula is a place, a land surrounded by water on the three sides. See, peninsula is a place, jaise hamara jo southern, India ka jo southern part hai. Aapko pata hai na, Bay of Bengal, then Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. That part, jo southern part hai, तीनों तरफ पानी से घिरा हुआ है, ऐसी जगह को हम पेनिनसुला बोलते हैं. अब पेनिनसुला इज अ पीस ऑफ लैंड सराउंडेड बाय वाटर ऑन द थ्री साइड एंड यूरोप इज डिस्क्राइब्ड एट अ पेनिनसुला ऑफ पेनिनसुला बिकॉज ऑफ द सेम रीजन. नाउ वी विल कंटिन्यू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. थैंक यू.